If we look at the schematic, I'll quickly switch to the tactical control center schematic. We can see all of these components, how they look like. So let's start for the SV setup, SV protocol. So we have the SV setup, SV publisher, and SV subscriber. And inside the SV setup, we can set the signal frequency and sample spur period for each of the Hill devices that you can choose here. So for 50 and 60 Hertz, we have 80 samples per period, and for the lower frequency, we can go to 256 samples. If we go to the publisher, you can define all the message fields, let's say. So we have destination MAC, user priority VLAN, and so on. I will not go into details, but you can also specify the application specific data unit, the ID, your configuration revision, synchronization, scaling type, and signal quality, which can be either through a variable, as it is right now, we have terminals, or it can be a fixed value specified for each signal, the quality. And you can also generate quality through this table. You can select all the fields. For the subscriber part, you can only specify the app ID and the SV ID, which is used to filter out the messages on the network, and select scaling for current voltages and the types of those signals. For the goose communication, it's a little bit different. If I go into, you need to specify the configuration file, and the standard IC6950 standard specifies the ICD, SSD, and SCD files as the configuration files. So you need to specify these files in order to run the goose communication. So if I select some SCD file, these combo boxes fill with data from that file, and you can select the ID if multiple IDs are specified in this configuration, and you can select the goose control block that you want to emulate. So here we have three of them specified. You can select one, and you can also see the data that is present for that goose configuration block. As you can see, the logic device, logical device name, logical node name, etc., and the data that is sent. Similar thing is for subscriber. You select the file that you want to subscribe to, the device that you want to subscribe to, and just select the dataset name. You can also see the data. And last, we have the MMS server. If we double click it, you can see the dialog window is much more complicated than the last one, and it also uses the configuration file to specify the configuration. So if we select another one, the ICD file here, if you click open, you can see that this tree view is filled, and with the configuration of the device, and you can see that there is a E1 test, logical node 0, and other logical nodes that you can select and see the data sets, this reporting block, and so on. And if you can select the logical node, and inside the logical node, you can see all the fields for mod, behavior, health, and so on and so on. And again, you can select, in order to connect the signal to this server, to this object, you can, let's say, if you want to instant magnitude to select to control this value, you need to select this include, to check this include box. If you select it, it will create a terminal on the component, and the type of terminal is defined here. Either it's input, it will create an input terminal, and you can put the signal that you want to read, or it can be an output terminal, meaning that the external client can write to this value and it will be an output of the component. So for example, let's put this as input, and you can specify the alias of this signal. I will just put like inst mag. Also, we can, for example, select the quality as an input. I'll put this Q, and let's say we want one output, and we will select, for example, let's say this one. So we select output, and I will not specify the alias here, just to see what will happen. This value is basically when you start the simulation, it will define the initial value before the client connects. So if we click connect, it will create all these terminals to connect to. So instant mag, Q, and if you don't specify alias, it will create this like generic name of the terminal. We can all of these protocols have the appropriate example files, which I will show you now. So if you go to file, open example model, you can navigate to communication, and you have here the IEC 61A50 Goose, MMS, two examples, and the sampled values, one example. So I will open first the sample values, and you have the receive, send, and exchange between two hills, which is just a example how to use both sending and receiving. I'll open this one, and you can see that this is a simple model of the rectifier and some current and voltage values. Here we can see the publisher components and one subscriber component. And if we look at the setup, because there are two hills marked with 0 and 1, we can select which one we want to configure and select the data and define the publishing messages. So if you look at this publisher, we can see it's a new SV message, all the data is filled, as well as the SV ID of type of example, and so on, quality, and so on and so on. And each if you click on the second one, we can see it's a sequence of application specific data unit. So each SV message can have multiple like this sets of currents and voltages, and here we just add to the first message data to the first message. So we choose the existing SV message, the previous one, and the index of 2, and then also define all the other fields. And in subscriber, we subscribe to one message that has the ID of the message that we defined, and the sample value of Typhoon example SV, which is this ID that we defined here. And it will basically the first hill will send the message, and the second hill will receive this message of these currents and voltages. Okay, going next to the Goose example, we can see it's a simple example, but you can see how everything is configured. Inside we have the SCD file loaded, selected control block, and in the subscriber there's exactly the same file and data set is selected to subscribe to. And because there is only one terminal, it must be a vector signal. And here we use bus join to join the values, and here to split the values using bus split. Going to the third example of MMS server, we can see here in the MMS component, the file is already loaded, and we can see all the signals that are selected to be controlled. So we have inputs, we have outputs, and so on. And here we can see how the instant magnitude can control all these values of instant magnitude, magnitude range and quality, and depending on this dead band, zero dead band and limiting factors that we can configure through the client. In this subsystem, there's just a logic that calculates all these values.
Thank you.